குயின் உறவுகள் அனைவருக்கும் அன்பான வணக்கம். நம்மளோட சேனல்ல அமரர் கல்கி எழுதின பொன்னியின் செல்வன் நாவல் தொடர்ந்து வந்து நீங்க ஆங்கில பதிவுல கேட்டு வந்துகிட்டே இருக்கீங்க. முந்தைய பதிவுல சாப்டர் 2 ஆழ்வார்க்கடியன் நம்பி நம்ம ஆரம்பிச்சிருந்தோம். ஸோ இதோட தொடர்ச்சி பார்ட் 2 வந்து இன்னைக்கு கேட்கலாம். பார்ட் 1ல நம்ம எதோட முடிச்சோம் அப்படின்னா, வந்தியத்தேவன் ஒரு க்ரௌடு வந்து பார்க்குறாரு. அவங்களுக்குள்ள வந்து நிறைய டிபேட்ஸ் வந்து நடக்குது. ஸோ அதை ஆர்வமாக பார்க்குறதுக்காக அவர் தயாராக இருக்கார். வாங்க கண்டினியூ பண்ணலாம். ஒன் மேன் வாஸ் வியரிங் த வைஷ்ணவா ரிலீஜியஸ் சிம்பல்ஸ் ஆல் ஓவர் ஹிஸ் பாடி. ஹீ ஹேட் அ டஃப் ஆஃப் ஹேர் ஆன் ஹிஸ் ஃபோர்ஹெட். ஹீ அப்பியர்ட் லைக் அ ஃபனட்டிக் வைஷ்ணவா. ஹீ வாஸ் ஆர்ம்டு வித் அ ஷார்ட் ஸ்டிக். He was short and plump and looked very strong. The second debater professed the religion of Shiva. He had smeared holy ash all over his body. The third was saffron-clad philosopher with a clean-shaven head. He was neither a Saiva nor a Vaishnava. He was an Advaitin, that is, follower of Sankaracharya. The Saiva shouted at the Vaishnava, "Oh, Alvarkadiyan Nambi, first answer my question. Didn't Vishnu and Brahma go in shirts of Shiva's feet and head respectively? And did they not take refuge in Shiva's feet after they failed in their mission? Didn't they concede that none could find the beginning or end of Lord Shiva? How the hell can you say that Vishnu is the greatest of the three?" Alvarkadiyan Nambi waved his stick menacingly at his opponents as he spoke. "Oh, Shiva Pata Tuli Pata, will you please stop that nonsense? Didn't your Shiva give a lot of boons to the ten-headed Ravana, the king of Lanka? Didn't all those boons go up in smoke before the mighty bow of a Lord Rama? How the hell can you say then that Shiva is the greatest of the lot?" The saffron-clad philosopher intervened with his sobering words. "Why are you wasting your time in these futile arguments? Even if you argue for hours on end, you can't decide whether Shiva is greater or Vishnu. Vedanta has answers for all your questions. So long as you are in the lowly path of devotion, these silly arguments will continue. Superior to the path of devotion is that of knowledge, and beyond that is Brahman. Once you attain the Brahmic state, there is neither Shiva nor Vishnu. Sarvam Brahmamayam Jahat, whatever there is only Brahman." Sri Sankaracharya explains in his commentaries on Brahma Sutra. Alvarkadiyan did not let him finish. "Stop that crap, will you? After writing elaborate philosophical commentaries on Bhagavad Gita, the Upanishads and the Brahma Sutra, your Sankara sang on my Lord. Baja Govindam, Baja Govindam, Govindam, Baja Mudame. Worship Govinda, oh you foolish mind." The Vaishnava stressed the word foolish and repeated it thrice. The crowd applauded the witty retort. The philosopher was furious. "You're right, I am a fool. Who put a fool would talk philosophy to a thick-headed idiot with a tuff on his head and a stick in his hand? Oh, sannyasi, this is no ordinary stick. This has the power to break your clean-shaven head should there be a need." The crowd hailed the Vaishnava's move. Alvarkadiyan aimed the stick at the philosopher's head. The philosopher shouted again, "Stop it, I say. Let the stick remain in your hand. If you are going to hit me with that damned stick, I won't be angry, nor will I fight with you. The one who beats is Brahman. The one who is beaten is Brahman. If you beat me, you will only end up beating your own self. I beg all of you to bear witness to this beautiful sight. The Supreme Brahman is going to give a holy beating to the Supreme Brahman, since according to his philosophy, he is me and I am him. I am going to hit myself with this stick. Alvakadiyan approached the philosopher with the raised stick. Vandiyathevan lost his cool. He wanted to grab the stick from the fanatic and thrash him with his own weapon. The philosopher merged into the crowd and vanished without a trace. The Vaishnava sympathizers hailed Alvakadiyan's victory. There was a perfect knockout. Alvakadiyan now turned to the only remaining foe. Pada Tuli Pata, shall we continue with the arguments, or you two are going to do the vanishing act like your philosopher friend? Me? Vanishing? No way! I am not like your Lord Krishna, who stole butter from the milkmaids and got beaten by them. What a shame! Your Shiva carried sand in consideration for some sweets and was scanned for his indiscipline and insubordination. Alvakadiyan now came near Butter, holding the stick in a threatening position. He was large and strong. The Saiva was lean and weak. The crowd soon divided themselves into two factions and were thirsting for a hands-on fight. Vandiyathevan wanted to put an end to all the foolishness happening in the name of religion. He came forward and shouted at the crowd, "Why are you fighting? Don't you have anything useful to do? If you really want to fight, go to Sri Lanka. There is a big war happening over there and you can do your duty to your motherland." Nambi turned to look at the intruder. "Who are you, man? Who gave you the authority to be the judge here?" The crowd was attracted to the young warrior. He looked very brave and was very handsome. They now expressed their solidarity to their prince of Vallam. "Tambi, you're right. Teach these people what is right. We are all with you." Vandiyathevan was happy to assume the post of the mediator that was thrust upon him. "I have never heard of Shiva and Vishnu fighting with each other. They are great friends. Why should this Nambi and that Butter fight on their behalf?" Many people laughed. "This young man appears to be a wise guy. But how can we settle the issue by mere witticisms? Let this Vaisrukrak answer the question straight. Who is the greater of gods, Shiva or Vishnu?" Butter spoke to the onlookers. "Both are equally great. You are free to worship whomsoever you like. Why should we fight?" Vandiyathevan's tone was conciliatory. Alvakadiyan was irritated. "That's baseless. What evidence do you have to prove that they are equal?" Vandiyathevan was now at his mischievous best. "You want evidence, right? Here you go. You know, yesterday I had been to Vaikuntham, the abode of Vishnu. Lord Shiva was also visiting Vishnu at that time. They were seated in chairs of equal height. Even their heights were equal. I know some dull head like you would insist on evidence, so I measured them both with my hands." "Are you trying to make fun of me?" Alvakadiyan was furious. Vandiyathevan was unfazed. The crowd wanted him to go on. "I was surprised. Lord Shiva and Lord Vishnu were of the same height, not an inch more or less. Even then I was not satisfied. I asked them point blank, which one of you is greater than the other? They replied in chorus, 'Shiva and Vishnu are one, you know. One who doesn't know is our foe. Sand into his mouth you all throw. So saying, the prince of Vallam opened his right hand and showed a handful of sand. The crowd shouted its approval. Soon, everyone was throwing sand on the heads of the two debaters. Miscreants, idiots, atheists. Alvarkadian shouted and entered the crowds as if to thrash everyone with a stick. There would have been a riot there but for the sudden noise that came from a little away. The most valiant, the bravest of the brave, the one who so valiantly attacked the army of Mara Pandian and destroyed it. The one who had fought 24 battles and bore 64 wounds on his body. The finance minister of Chola Kingdom. The minister of agriculture. And the one who is in charge of the state granary. The one vested with the exclusive authority to levy taxes and collect them. The senior Paluvetaraiyar is coming. Move aside and give way. The royal crier was announcing the visit of the dignitary. He was followed by a group of drummers who made rhythmic sounds with their timed beats. They were followed by a group of soldiers armed with shining spears marching majestically to the drumbeat. A huge decorated elephant followed them. On the pachydern was seated a large black man that was like dark clouds sitting atop a mighty mountain. Vandiyathevan joined the crowd which stood on either side of the road to have a glimpse of the senior Paluvetaraiyar. Behind the elephant came a palanquin covered on both sides by a shining silk screen. Before the Prince of Vallam could guess who would be inside the palanquin, a very fair, beautiful, handfully laden with bangles came out from the screen and slightly moved it. Like the shining moon in its full splendor slowly emerging out of the clouded skies, a beautiful woman's face appeared. Vandiyathevan was in the prime of his youth. Like any man of his age, he loved seeing beautiful women. The woman's face was extraordinarily beautiful. A sight like that should have sent waves of ecstasy to his youthful heart. But for some mysterious reason, the happiness and the ecstasy was not complete. There was a feeling of discomfort. At the same time, the lady's eyes were focusing on something near Vandiyathevan. The next second, he heard a mild scream from the woman. The screen was immediately drawn. The moon hid behind the clouds once again. Vandiyathevan looked around. The woman should have seen something scary. That explained the strange noise she made and the speed with which she pulled down the screen. Vandiyathevan saw Alvarkadian leaning on a tamarind tree with his eyes trained on the beautiful lady. My dear friends, chapter 2 is getting over here. I will soon see with chapter 3, the Vishnu temple. Okay, நண்பர்களே, மீண்டும் உங்களை அடுத்த பதிவில் சந்திக்கிறேன். என்றும் இணைந்திருங்கள் இங்கிலீஷ் குயின்ஸ் தமிழ் இன்ஃபோ அண்ட் விலாஸ் சேனலுடன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.